Ladies and gentlemen, as we honor our graduates and celebrate together, we ask that you help us preserve the dignity of the occasion by maintaining the appropriate decorum and respect. All members of the audience must remain in their seats throughout the ceremony and recessional. Fire laws prohibit guests from blocking the aisles to take pictures. Photographs must be taken from your seats only. Thank you.
Everyone, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the singing of the national anthem.
Good evening, families and friends. Most importantly, good evening, Carver Center class of 2019. Class, we made it. We have waited 4 years for this moment. 4 years of getting up early to catch the bus, even though it has already started pulling off. 4 years of staying up late to study for that test the next day. And for me and my dance class, 4 years of hearing Miss Royal say, get the bars, and Miss Steph saying, 5, 6, 7, 8, let's go. Although our time here at Carver wasn't the easiest, I know we can say that we wouldn't trade the memories we made here for anything in this world. Coming to Carver was an experience like no other. Waking up and coming to school, you never knew what the day would bring. Will Peter swing his belts? Will Groove Machine give a flash performance in the commons? Will there be a man walking around that we would soon discover is our new hall monitor? Or will there be a protest in the commons? Carver Center has been our home for the last 4 years. It is a place that has allowed us to grow and inspired us to be better, while also helping us realize our dreams, passions, and values. It is a place that has caused us joy, pain, laughter, and sadness. We have found friends here. We have lost friends here. We have smiled here, we have cried here, but most importantly, we have grown here, and Carver has prepared us for the world. Class, we are about to embark on a new journey. Yes, we will have challenges, but they will be fantastic learning experiences. So today, as we celebrate, don't think of this as the end. Think of this as a new beginning. Lastly, I want to thank the teachers here on this stage and the teachers before us for all the hard work and time put in and day out. You have helped mold us into the beautiful, intelligent, talented young adults we are now. I would also like to thank not only my family, but all the families here for supporting us, loving us, and never letting us give up, even when we wanted to. And to my class, thank you for allowing me to be president of the greatest, baddest, fiercest, and littest class to walk through the halls of Carver Center. Thank you. Now, please join us in welcoming Carver Center's amazing principal, Miss Karen Steele.
Greetings, everyone, and on behalf of the Carver Center administration, faculty, and staff, I want to welcome everyone to commencement 2019. Today marks our 24th graduation, our 26th year in existence. I want to take a moment to acknowledge some very special people who are here to celebrate with us this evening. It is a special honor to have with us the interim superintendent of Baltimore County Public Schools, Ms. Berlita White. Also on stage with us today, Dr. Mary McComas, Baltimore County Public Schools Interim Chief Academic Officer. Carver Center is honored to welcome to commencement 2019 Board of Baltimore County Public Schools School Board members, Ms. Julie Henn, Ms. Lily Rowe. In addition, I am pleased to welcome to our commencement the Honorable Delegate Michelle Goitan and Councilman David Marks. Also on stage with us today is Ms. Margaret Ann Howey, Esquire, General Counsel for Baltimore County Public Schools. Mr. Kevin Smith, Chief Administrative and Operations Officer. And I am pleased to welcome to their first Carver Center commencement our Community Superintendent, Ms. Christina Byers, and our Executive Director for High Schools, Mr. Samuel Mustafer. I need to acknowledge the two people who on any given day deal with anything and everything and anybody and everybody and always with the best interests of Carver Center students at heart. Assistant Principal, Ms. Allison Becker, and Class of 2019, your grade level administrator, Mr. Timothy Arrington. Please join me in acknowledging two people who have steered the class of 2019 through 4 years at Carver Center, your class advisors, Ms. Angela Stanford and Ms. Megan Bramstrom. Next, a huge thank you and acknowledgement goes to the person who has made everything happen today, our graduation coordinator, Ms. Maria Tazelarno. There is a group of people here who really need no introduction, but they certainly deserve one. The collaboration, respect, and tradition of excellence that are the hallmarks of Carver Center culture are the result of their commitment, of their devotion, and of their belief in the young people seated here today. It is a pleasure and an honor to recognize the faculty and staff of Carver Center. They're back there. There is one more group that I want to salute tonight. To our parents and our families in attendance, thank you. Thank you for your support, for your sacrifices, for letting us educate your student and watch them grow. Parents, family, and friends, thank you for everything that you have done for our Carver Center community every day. The young people seated here, our graduating seniors, follow in the footsteps of 26 years of brave, passionate, and creative Carver Center students. It has become a tradition over our past 24 graduations that the principal introduced the class. So it is my honor and pleasure to introduce you to this outstanding group of young people. And tonight, as you look at this class, you see what Carver Center is all about. And you see it visually as they wear some of the recognitions they have received. Take note of the medals, the cords, and the pins that reflect the hard work, dedication, and commitment to doing that which they are passionate about at Carver Center. They haven't just maintained a tradition of excellence, they have defined it. This is Carver Center's class of 2019.
Baltimore County Public Schools Interim Superintendent Ms. Verlita White has been actively engaged with the Carver community since she took on her latest role. She supported us and became a regular visiting presence at our school.
Ms. White has helped us by reminding us constantly that she will do what is best for the students. Her decisions and her focus on creating learner-centered environments show that she is committed to meeting the needs of the whole child while continuing supporting the teachers as well. Ms. White has been an integral part of Baltimore County Public Schools since 1995. She began as a teacher before deciding to become a mentor, then an assistant principal, and finally a principal. After meeting so many goals within the schools directly, Ms. White transitioned to the central office where she rose to the ranks first as a coordinator of leadership development, executive director of professional development, area assistant superintendent for the Northeast area, and assistant superintendent for elementary schools. She has also been earnestly involved as a chief academic officer in communicating the vision of school system while also motivating her staff. That motivation led to the surging graduation rates and the elimination of the graduation gap. She has actively sought our input, and we thank her for making us feel like a valued member of her team. We are grateful for her support and know that she has worked hard to help us achieve our goals. We are proud to have her as a member of the Carver community. Please let me present Ms. Verlita White.
So good evening. Oh, we can do better than that. Good evening. There we go. Don't our graduates look amazing? You look really good. I am so proud of you, and I know that I speak for everyone on this stage when I say that we are so incredibly proud of you. You have worked hard, you've persevered, you got going, you got it done, even maybe when you didn't feel like it. And so for that, we congratulate you tonight. So congratulations on your honor tonight, on your accomplishment. Keep in mind, though, that you did not get here alone. It's just as Principal Steele said, you've had the support of your family members and your friends and your loved ones who cared for you and nurtured you and loved you along the way. I know I would like to see where our parents and grandparents and guardians. Will you stand for a second? And I'd like for our graduating seniors, give your parents a round of applause. Thank you for loving and encouraging and nudging your children along the way. And this day could not be possible, certainly, without all of the planning, the hard work, the dedication, and the commitment of your teachers and your administrators. Would the faculty and staff and administrators of Carver Center please stand so that we can celebrate you this evening? Thank you for your hard work. And now to our graduating seniors. You know, when you cross the stage tonight, you're not just crossing the stage with a diploma in hand. You are crossing the stage with a resume of experiences and skills where you will have a leg up on the competition. When it comes to you going into college, or going into the military, going into the workforce, you will have a resume of skills because that's how we've prepared you. For instance, many of you are graduating tonight, and you already have college credits under your belt because of the AP courses that you've taken. If you fall into that category, stand up so that we can celebrate you tonight. Thank you. If you are graduating tonight and you have a specialized skill set, you're working toward an industry credential, maybe you have an industry credential, you have a specialized skill set in IT and cosmetology and culinary, would you stand up so that we can celebrate you? Thank you. If you are graduating tonight and you are proficient in a second or third or even a fourth language, stand up so that we can see you and celebrate you tonight. Thank you. And the list goes on and on and on. This is what we call a gift with purchase. When you go to the store and you get that little something extra with your purchase, tonight you are getting a gift with your purchase, with your diploma. You're getting that resume of skills and experiences that will give you a leg up on the competition. My charge to you is to be responsible with your gift. Cherish your gift and use your gifts for good. Give back to your country, to your community, to your neighborhoods, and be a mentor for your friends and those who are looking to you for inspiration. That's how you can determine success. You know, Maya Angelou says that success is liking yourself, liking what you do, and liking how you do it. Class of 2019, I wish you all the success in the world. Congratulations.
Good evening. My name is Angela Ohms, and I'm the treasurer for the class of 2019. Julie Henn has worked in education technology for more than 20 years and is currently Chief Information Officer and Director of Technology for Quality Matters, a global leader in quality assurance for online learning. She holds an MBA from Loyola University in Maryland and a bachelor's degree in communications from Marquette University. Ms. Henn is a lifelong resident of Baltimore County and has long been active in public education, serving in multiple PTA leadership roles. Most recently, she served as chair of the Northeast Area Education Advisory Council for Baltimore County. She and her husband have two children and a son and daughter and live in Perry Hall. Please welcome the Honorable Julie Henn, Baltimore County's Board of Education Vice Chair.
Good evening, Carver Class of 2019. It is an honor to be with you this evening and to bring greetings on behalf of the Board of Education of Baltimore County. We recognize and we celebrate your dedication, your hard work, and the sacrifices you've made to pursue your education. And we are tremendously proud of each of you. Our hope is that the energy, excitement, and pride you feel at this moment remain with you as you begin your next adventure and for a lifetime. And as you look around and see so many smiling faces here tonight, know that your community shares in your pride and that we will be here to cheer you every step of the way. Congratulations.
It is a Carver Center tradition that a member in the top 5% of the senior class present an address to the class during the graduation ceremony. Before she begins, it is my honor and pleasure to introduce you to this year's speaker, Katia Van Landingham. In her 4 years at Carver Center, Katia has lived the tradition of excellence that is Carver Center. And in doing so, she has excelled both in her academics and her prime. She has taken the most difficult courses available to her and has achieved a GPA of 3.84 and a QPA of 5.516. Katia has been a member of the National Honor Society, National English Honor Society, National French Honor Society, National Social Studies Honor Society, and Chess Club. She has also volunteered at Magnet Assessments, Magnet Expo, and as a math tutor. A member of the Visual Arts Prime, Katia graced the pages of the January 2019 issue of Towson Lifestyle magazine as one of Carver Center's profiled artists. She also presented her process and works at this year's Magnet Schools of America National Conference. Katia has been recognized as an AP Scholar with Distinction and in Scholastics, Arts, and Writing Awards with 12 awards, 7 honorable mentions, 4 silver keys, and 1 gold key. With all she does at Carver Center, she finds time to participate in activities outside of school, including acoustic guitar and ice skating, which she began in 5th grade and is now at the freestyle 2 level. Katia will attend Yale University in the fall. It is with great pride that I now present to you this talented young woman, your graduation speaker for the class of 2019, Katia Van Landingham.
Okay. At any other school, I think it's fairly safe to assume that the sounds of chainsaws ringing through the hallways would cause alarm. A piano in the lunchroom would probably be seen as a prank, and the intoxicating smells of culinary would likely be written off as the hallucinations of hungry teenagers. At Carver, we have become accustomed to the extraordinary. Dancers leaping in perfect synchronization are simply a commonplace of the halls, and massive, beautiful paintings are a blur as we rush to class. However, the fact that these incredible things have become regular parts of our lives does not in any way diminish their worth or the effect they have had on us. The fact that we have been constantly surrounded by the furthest extents of creativity and enthusiasm means that our own potential and imagination have been stretched farther than we ever thought they could be. Although senioritis has been creeping up on us for quite a while, for some of us before we were even seniors, I think I speak for all of us when I say it feels strange to actually be here. In these last few weeks, our lives have become such a whirlwind of anticipation and anxiety, tearful goodbyes, and excitement for what comes next. High school is a strange period of time. Simultaneously, we are children and young adults, not trusted to go to class from class without a pass, and yet expected to make huge decisions that will alter the course of our future. It can be overwhelming to attempt to fit so many roles at once, while at the same time trying to figure ourselves out outside of these expectations. In our next phase of life, it would be naive to assume that these conflicts disappear. No matter how old you are or how much you have achieved, expectations of who you should be or what you should be doing will always stand present in the back of your mind. It is because of this that I ask you to take a step back and appreciate how far we've come. How at the ages of 17 and 18, you've become officially licensed in cosmetology and culinary fields. How by senior year of high school, you have written and directed plays, starred in musicals, and held audiences captive with your beautiful voices. Not to mention the 7 of you who are published authors, the number of you who can program games and write complex codes, the innovative designers of beautiful sets and costumes, the sculptors, the filmmakers, the creators. So in this moment, this whirlwind, as the many aspects of life clamor loudly for your attention, try to take a moment to appreciate the beauty of this chaos. Try to see the millions of paths ahead, the millions of decisions to make, not as stressful and obligatory, but as bursting with opportunity. Alongside the obstacles of our age, we should note that we currently hold both more freedom than we have ever had before, and all the exciting opportunities and privileges of an entire future ahead of us. As our many paths diverge, it's hard to imagine that the next step could ever contain the same kindness of people and incredible range of talent that we've grown accustomed to at Carver. But it's equally hard to imagine ever forgetting all that has happened here or ever spending a day not being a better person because of it. Though it's unlikely that dancers parading the halls or the buzzing of chainsaws will continue to be commonplaces in our future, at least not for all of us, I have no doubts that each and every one of us will continue to discover and contribute to all the beautiful things that make our world extraordinary.
It is my privilege to present to you the class of 2019 for the conferring of diplomas.
As a member of the Board of Education of Baltimore County, and along with Board Member Lily Rowe, I certify that these seniors have met all of the requirements set forth by Baltimore County Public Schools and the state of Maryland. By the power vested in me, I hereby declare the class of 2019 to be graduates of Carver Center. Congratulations.
Thank you. You may now be seated. Naya Brielle McKenney. Louisa Sophia Friedman. Alexandra Patrice Huettner. Ricardo Angelo B. Ohms. Jana Beth Russ. Kaya Brooke Abramson. Grace Shannon. Katia Elena Van Landingham. Jade Alexandra Bucher. Rebecca Denny. Jillian Lane Fleischer. Will Sawyer Fui. Anderson Maria Gray. Jonathan J. Guerrero. Calvin Israel. Nana Simone Egu Kalu. John Carlos Rivera Lai. Christopher Lattis. Grace Nazarian. Kayla Zanae Thompson. Elizabeth Driscoll Volpe. Catherine Elizabeth Zimmer. Maddie Abdelmumni. Zaire Verdell Abdul Rahim. Jasmine Damilola Akintoye. Akbar Ali. Shivani Ali. Nicholas Anderson. Nicholas Shane Brady Ashley. Madeline Kiersey Aspelmeyer. Tyler Back. Michaela Leonora Bala. Louise Barron. Beatriz Benavides.
Seth Bennett. Colin Michael Birch. Lauren Nicole Bess. Asia Bethia. Jada Shalia Boyd. Grace Elizabeth Brown. Taylor Marie Brown. Margaret Bryan. Sammy Biyun. Riley Karina Carden Hubers. Janaea Simone Carrington. Austin Nasir Carver. Nisia Grace Cataldi. Anarda Brianne Chapman. Nat Donovan Chavis. James D. Claxton IV. Caroline D. Coker. Lauren Elizabeth Cole. Micheline Claudia Collins. Desmond Joshua Cook. Eliza Cooper. Matthew Coles. Tita Nichelle Crippen. Noah Christ. Keegan Marie Crockett. Alima Jamila Dakins. Madison Dale Randolph. Diamond Patrice Davis. Danae Cheyenne Davis. Kira C. Della Camera. Christian Diaz. Catherine Riley Doggett. Emma Jane Doherty. Haley Downs. Danielle S. Edwards. Antonio Rafael Perez Isma. Catherine Elkins. Minor Leonardo Escobar. Xavier Jimmy Escobar. Franco E. Espina. Lydia Jolie Etham. Jordan Simone Evans. Jordan Nicole Evans. Teo Fleet. Rayanne Birch. Alyssa L. Fox. Molly Gaither. Aaron Garrett. Brandon Isaiah James Gatewood. Elizabeth Joki Gatanye. Joelle Arlington Gentry. Joshua Gibson. Sydney Elizabeth Gibson. Jackson Goldsmith. Ricky Chandra Green. Kayla Griswold. Olivia Heidi Gruber. Jada Harris. Rachel Marie Harris. Zachary Harris. Sydney Janae Carrad. Micah S. Havens. Anna Hyder. Chloe Naomi Healy's. Najee Nicole Hemingway. Marguerite Heyer. Phoenix A. Holly. Jordan Alexa Howard. Janaya Zaye Irby. Jasmine Amber Adwa Asabia Jackson. Caitlin Cynthia Johnson. Cole Jeremy Johnson. Cole Scott Johnson. Jeremiah Christian Johnson. Kayla Johnson. Jada Ruth Imani Jones. Mackenzie Diana Jones. Jason Juarez. June Keating. Rachel Kiefer. Madison Kennedy. Maggie Knapp. Minna Marie Knight. Samuel A. Koch. Ethan Russell Kreidler. Fung Wen Lam. Mary C. Howe Lowry. Dominique Alexis Lee. David Ray LaRue, Jr. Julia Faye Letke. Malachi Jalen Love. Isabella Sophie Lytle. Savannah Lynn Malinowski. Catherine Esquivel Marcotte. Michael B. Mays. Mason McLaren. Trenton A. Mercadel. Shayla Nicole Merritt. Leora Mervis. Katrina A. Miles. Sophie Michelle Miller. Michelle Milter. Elizabeth Malenik. Kamari Montgomery. Miles Moody. Abigail Ruth Murray. Peter Moosey. Mackenzie Sierra Myers. Lila Mosaic. Allison Naglieri. Kareen Akosiwa Abimbola Nivi. Brianna Lynn Oglesby. Toluwani Akinlolu Ojumu. Sarah Marie Orvis. Jocelyn Renee Parker. Taylor Shervon Partlow. Jada Lee Patterson. Natalia Stefania Pavlik. Katie Pedro. Lisa Maria Raven Tay Peoples. Kalia Perry. Savannah Lynn Petrelli. Emma Peel. Rachel Prem. Mark Postavoit. Jet Chu. Christina Raslova. Anissa Reed. Elizabeth Rose Resch. Amelia Reno. Amelia Lythe Reynolds. Sophia Rienzi. Trinity Alexis Grace Robinson. Haley Roddy. Jabria Nicole Rogers. Janae Danielle Rogers. Victor Manuel Rosas. Brianna Francis Safran. Daniela Sedano. Ashni Kaur Sethi. Braylon Alexandra Scholl. Sydney Sharon. Clayton R. Smallwood. Noah Toriano Smith. Sydney Michelle Smith. Eric Sean Snowden. Tyrese Amir Solomon Springer. Rachel Stettina. Robert C. Stuckey. Abhay Suresh. Caden Thomas Swank. Tracy Franklin Lamont Taft Jr. Janelle Ann Tamayo. Evan Michael Trevier. Emma Sage Filker. Constantina Stavroula Tamakos. Christina Andrea Thompson. Julia Lauren Tivis. Christina Nicole Trice. Eric Michael Wagner. Sean Michael Walters. Joshua David Ward. Jacob Carl Weigley. Simone Erica White. Jaron Nadir Williams. Nibia S. Williams. Russell Williams. Jasmine Wilson. Aiden Andrew Woodward. Michael David Young. Saheed G. Young. Katia Zaydelis.
Good evening, friends, family, faculty, and of course, fellow graduating seniors. Good evening, friends, family, faculty, and of course, fellow graduating seniors. We entered Carver Center as young, naive freshmen, hatching out of our childhood and getting a taste of what we thought meant being grown. Here we are, 4 years later, as young adults, preparing ourselves to leave the nest and go out into the real world. From being a part of Carver's first pep rally, to orchestrating successful food fundraisers and wild and out shows, to planning incredible junior and senior proms, we have triumphed as a class and raised more money than we could have expected. Admittedly, we've hit many bumps in the road, but we always get back up, dust ourselves off, and carry on. Fellow classmates, I now ask that we all come together for a couple of graduation traditions. A little over a year ago, we received our class rings at junior ring ceremony. On that night, we turned our rings towards us to symbolize our growth as students and to prepare for our greatest high school moments. Tonight, we are ready to move beyond Carver Center and into the world. Tonight, we will turn our rings out toward the world. Members of the class of 2019, please remove your ring and turn it so that it faces outward with the writing facing away from you, and then put it back onto your finger. Our final adjustment to our ring seals our bond that each one of us has with Carver Center and allows us to move forward into the world using Carver Center as another block on our foundation. Every day of the future, our rings will remind us of the 4 years spent here and will help us reminisce about the relationships and memories we have formed, which we will carry with us forever.
We're not quite done. We have set a single tradition, we have set a single tradition left that we will make us official Carver Center graduates. This action symbolizes the new career of our lives that is ready to begin. Class of 2019, please stand. At this time, please take your tassel and move it from the right to the left. Ladies, gentlemen, and those who identify differently, I am proud to present to you the 2019 graduates at George Washington Carver Center for Arts and Technology. Woo! Beginning and the start of a great journey. Congratulations, class of 2019. In the words of Dr. Seuss, don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. Please be seated.
Oh. stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, we don't want your broken parts.
I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say,
no one will love you as you are.
Break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious. When the sharpest words wanna cut me down, I'm gonna send the blood, gonna drown them out.
I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me.
Look out, cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum.
I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. This is me.
We are bursting through the barricades and reaching for the sun.
We are
warriors. Yeah, that's what we've become.
Oh, let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us.
For the glory!
Please honor our graduates by remaining seated until all the graduates and stage party have recessed out of the CQ arena. You'll be able to join your graduates outside on the patio where you entered the arena. Thank you.